know you wanted to be a model?
I knew I wanted to be a model when I was in my ISS class. And my teacher, Ms. Knopf from Palmer Middle School, she told me, you know, Stedmon, you have great skin, you have that facial features, you're tall, you're socially active, because I kept getting sent there. So she was like, you should take your talents and try modeling. And by fate, I heard a casting call for 21st Century Entertainment on the radio. And I told my mom I really wanted to try this out. And I went, I got some photos together, they liked my look, and basically the rest is history.
This is my time. This is my hour. This is my pain. This is my name. This is my power. If it's my rain, then it's my shower. This pole position, I made a lane because they blocked out.
What's the hardest part about being a model?
Oh, God. The hardest part about being a model, you have to have thick skin. You have to be able to embrace failure, because you'll hear more no's than any yeses. So you just have to be persistent and just have faith in yourself and know that it only takes one time for you to really take off in your career. And as long as you stay persistent, have faith, and keep working on your craft, you'll make it.
First of all, where's your audience?
Right here.
Okay, why do you have your back shoulder to me then?
Thank you. Because I was going to come.
Right, no, all right. Yeah. The moment I see you, the moment you can see an audience member, they can see you, that means you have to be on.
Right.
The moment I lay eyes on you, you're on. Okay, yeah. So you can't do this, can't do this.
Right.
Can't do this, can't, no, you're on.
Right.
Okay?
Exactly.
All right, so go ahead. Okay. Okay, stop back. I'm going to stop you because I'm doing this for the purpose. Okay, so the moment I said start, you went like this. You pierced your lips, and you looked down. Okay, we're looking at you. The audience, you're on. Mm-hmm. So you can't, you're on.
Right.
So
there we go. Okay.
Yeah. Okay, no, wait, here's the deal.
It's awkward.
No,
you're
no,
like,
no. Okay, here's what you do. Okay. 45 degree angle to the audience.
Okay.
You're in a hesitation, and obviously you have squared shoulders to the camera. I'm a woman, so I have the S curve. You're a man, so you have a V. Big strong shoulders down to a point and talk and walk with the show foot, right? But shoulders back, remember your hands are by your side seam.
Okay.
And not touching.
Right.
But yeah.
Okay.
All right, go ahead. And up you. All right, stop. You're taking little steps, that little step thing. You should get down this runway in like four steps instead of those small steps. I want full extended steps. It's not a robotic kind of runway, right? You've got to flow and smooth it out. Look at us in the eyes. Have some flirtation.
Have you ever wanted to give up on modeling?
No. Actually, no, that's a lie. Yeah, there was like times when I was younger, I was discouraged because like I wasn't getting booked as quickly as I thought I would be. But after making a conscious decision with myself, this is something I'm going to do for the rest of my life. No, I wouldn't give it up.
Look right at the camera. Look at the camera this time. Turn back around. Look at me now. Long steps. Full steps. And do a nice pivot at the top, and then off you go. Right? Looking at me all the way down. Looking at me all the way down. There you go. And just like that. That's how it happens. Yeah. But at least the instruction part, you know, you can hear better when I'm yelling like that, right?
See? Modeling is not that easy. What I do for my preparation for my shoots is, one, look up the client. Get in the right mindset and, you know, just get my look, like, on fleek, as people would say. Like, haircut, hair done, facial maybe. You gotta look the part first. And then listen to a lot of music, get that energy up, because that's what photographers want to see. is you bringing that natural energy to the shoot.
You see this motherfucker?
Blessings, blessings, my head. I see elephant's house on the bow of a sailing lady. Docked on the Ivory Coast, Mercedes in a row, winding down the road. I hope my black skin don't dirt this
right,
white.
Here, Bobcat Studios with Derek Blake, photo shoot, Stedmon player, aka the Mutedbandit. Some great photographers making me look real good, like real good. I would give y'all a sneak peek, but it's in the vault. But I did want to ask him a really quick question. Like, what would you tell like aspiring models who want to be that need that exposure to get to those higher agencies and to actually be a working model in the industry?
As an aspiring model, it's important that, you know, you guys test. That's the most important thing.
Yes.
You know, and do the investment of your research or investing in established photographers. You know, there's so many good photographers, and the first thing you should ask is, do you do test work, and then what's your test rate? And invest in it, because ideally, if you're not there, or it's the image is there, and it's going to get you the job first, or even get you to walk in. So stay current. You know, make sure that your look is constantly updated, so you don't look one way, and then when you go to a casting, it looks a different way.
Right.
Constantly look at magazines, LW. You know, even the early.
You're in all the magazines.
like you will be, and like you
appreciate
are now.
That. I appreciate it.
Yeah,
that.
I'm working to the screens like you though.
Okay.
So I mean, all types of magazines, from urban to editorial, and to kind of see what they're looking, what kind of models they're casting, and what kind of image or what category you fit in.
Right.
You know, it's important to know your demographic, your category, what your market is, so you know what images to take to kind of go after that. And then, you know, do like yourself, you know, get out there, invest in your craft, it pays off later. You know, you're in countless movies doing your thing, and just build your book. You know, there's value in paid assignments, but there's also value in non-paid assignments depending on it. It's important to kind of realize what's important and what's not, because there's a lot of useless stuff out there too, but right. You know, every opportunity isn't paid.
Right.
So, you know, just invest in yourself and the rest will come.
Great from the man himself, thanks, man. So take that advice and just pursue your modeling career, stay back to your dream, and we're about to create some more heat, so yeah.
Well, fuck it, because this water drowned my family, this water makes my blood. This water tells my story. This water knows it all. Go ahead and spill some champagne in the water. Go ahead and watch the sun blaze on the waves of the ocean.
Can I put the headphones on?
No.
He said no.
No. This is the lab.
Let go.
No, we're shooting. Bro, I'm doing my interview right now for the documentary, and it's looking pretty legit. Me, Shell, my sister, Will's here, man, like the whole pop culture fam in my camp.
The idea behind Mutedbandit came to play when I saw how Stedmon dressed, and the word bandit came to mind. And matching with my style of photography, which is a little bit more dull colors, the idea of muted came to mind as well. So I fused those words together and got Mutedbandit. That's how Mutedbandit came together. And we shot that in last year, summer 2014.